Hi, I'm Gabrielle, and I'm going to be your instructor for this short course on Swift syntax. Swift is already having a huge impact on iOS development. It's fast, concise, easy to read, and comes with tools like playgrounds that make it easier than ever to visualize your code. A welcoming language for beginner and intermediate programmers, Swift makes the road to building your own iOS apps considerably less steep. Fantastic resources for learning Swift are easy to find. Not least among them is Apple's guide, the Swift programming language, which we hope you'll come to rely on as a reference. This course hopes to offer something that is less common among other Swift resources, practice. Throughout the course, we'll be working through examples together, and each lesson will end with a set of exercises to get you more comfortable with Swift's idiosyncrasies.
We'll start out with some basics of types and operators, and practice manipulating strings and declaring variables and constants. Then we'll move on to what is arguably Swift's most unique and confounding feature, optional types. We'll talk about collections and control flow, including lots of practice with switch statements, functions and classes, enumerations and structs, which are considerably more powerful in Swift than in other languages, protocols, and we'll wrap things up by exploring closure expressions, which can be tricky at first, but wonderfully convenient once you get the hang of them.
This course is designed for programmers who have some prior object-oriented experience, for students who, through work with other languages, are already familiar with most of the concepts I've just listed. So let's get started with Swift types.